Hello, today I have a frill skirt and my customer said it too big on her and I want to find a way to take it one in. On the back it has elastic. At the rear I want to take in about this much. And at the left side we will do the same. Have too much fabric on it and the lining is inside as well. So my idea is we still keep elastic on the back. So I mark inside this and then a little bit at this side as well. And a little bit here as well. Yeah. Okay, I take the pin off. The lining is not free, so it's stuck with this line, and with this line block it, and this line as well. I pin 1, 2, 3, but seam to the seam together. And this is stay outside, so I don't worry about this. So I take this one off. Okay, I take this one off to get this light stay free. And now you don't worry about this one anymore. So our job is tap this one in from the waist in and in until the end here. And if you want it easy, you can take this one a little bit more. This frill now stay away from one side seam. So now I want to cut it. And then this is the seam size. I put the seam size down. And before I mark from here and from here, so I will cut it like the V from here to here and here. Yeah. Okay. Sorry, I cut this V off. Then another size, I will do the same. So if you think the frill stay here, it's hard for you to do the job, you can cut the frill off and make it a little bit smaller as well. So I put the frill away and then I pin this one. So I just do the job from inside and the, yeah, make sure nothing under here. And I will do like other size. I draw it up. And this one the same. Yeah. So, and now I cut the V off, but I have to have 1 centimeter for the sewing. If you want it easy to sew, you can pin along here. But this is 100% cotton, so very easy to set up it, pin it. And now the dress a little bit heavy, so I want to put the new elastic in here. I put elastic on the top here and then I sew one end. And then this side I will do the same. Yeah. Ok, Okay, the stitching undone a little bit here, by the way. I sew this one back on. Yeah. And now about this part. Now on the right hand side, I want to sew along this seam. This stitching line will guide me when I put two of them together at the end here. Yeah. So now I put two of them together and then I sew it. Okay, the top part, I have no problem. I just put the outside and lining together and outside and lining together, and then you pin before already. So now we just run it. And now I have the stitching guideline here. So now I make this one stay, and then I fold this, I follow this line, and I sew along here as I make the dot and a little bit out until nothing. And if we do this way, when we turn the outside, it looks very nice and the seam did not show up at the end. Now we can overlock this part. I overlock already. I overlock already. Now I don't want it to stay like this, so I turn it to one side and I want to block this. Okay, I put one stitch in here to make the seam stay. On the right hand side, I put the seam together already, and on the left hand side, I don't want to do it now. I want to keep it open to get it easy to do the frill for the right hand side. Yeah, on the dress, it's already have the line for gathering here, so now I want to borrow this line to gather it, but I have to make sure the other end, the stitching stay, otherwise it come up the whole line. So I lock this one. To lock this, take the stitching at the bottom, take the stitching on the top, and then pull both of them to different sides, and then it block. So now I put this one together and I pull it. The important is the seam, to go with the seam here. So I have to pin this. Yeah. So this side is better now. Now I do another side. I pull it. Yeah, I think I can start now. We have to sew on the original line. To make it nice, I have to sew it on the gathering line. Yeah, and middle to middle already. And now I set up this side. Okay, I put on the same line. Okay, one side we did already, line to line, in the gather, in the seam side. Yeah, and now I do another side. I need to sew. Yeah. If we don't sew this line for guiding, we still can, but we may show off this one outside, so it looks not good. I use a guideline to fold this. Okay, this size, we lost the gathering line. So now I have to make the new one and then I gather again. To start, remember backward forward to lock the thread and then adjust the stitching a little bit wider. And so try to sew on the same line. Okay, and this end I don't lock it because I use this end for gathering. So I take the stitching on the top and then I pull this. You can have another way to gather this one. Original line here. I want to put middle to middle here. Yeah. And then I move the gathering both sides to make it even. Yes, and this side. Okay, I put the new line to go with the original line. Okay, I finished already. Remember inside, if you put the seam that way, every joint you have to do the same that way. Yeah. In this case, I just tuck in the first row and second row only, because if you want to tap in more this size, you need to take off this frill and this frill stay inside between two pieces, so this one harder. And the first row we have is stay outside. So now you can see it's very much smaller at the waist and the hip.